what would it be like to fly a small plane from the lower 48 through Canada all the way to Alaska. Today, we're gonna fly this Cessna 172 from Vinita, Oklahoma, all the way up to Palmer, Alaska. What is it, 3,700 miles?
Roughly, yeah.
I think we're gonna have ourselves quite the adventure. What do you think?
I think so too, we're gonna find out.
And if things get really hairy, it's gonna get really exciting. So, hope you guys enjoy this.
Flare.
Jim Kelly Field, I was just making sure that was the right one. Okay.
Okay, let's check your brakes here.
Okay, my brakes are good.
Go down and run up.
Your controls.
Well, I guess we'll do the run up down there to four at the other end.
Yeah, sounds good. When I grow up, I want to be a bush pilot, and kind of the beginning of that journey is this adventure right here. So I figure if I can fly all the way up to Alaska, I can become a bush pilot.
Vinita traffic, Skyhawk 314XR, you're gonna be back taxi at 35, Vinita. Nobody's doing anything.
I don't see anybody.
Well, I wanted to sell the plane, but Josh somewhat convinced me it'd be fun to make this trip up to Alaska with it. Boy, was I mistaken.
All right, so we're running down to the south end of the runway. Mike's gonna do a quick run up for us. Where, you wanna fly this leg?
Sure.
Okay, you'll fly this leg. I might do the instrument approach going into that airfield. So we're actually going to fly into, what did I say, Lexington?
Lexington.
Yeah, so Lexington, Nebraska. That's about a four-hour flight. We're not going to show you guys all that, but we'll just hit the highlights. And a coyote? I bet we caught that on the camera. That's cool. All righty, let's do the run-up and let's get going.
Good.
Looks good. The old engine looks like she's going to hold up for a trip to Alaska. Are you ready?
Think so.
All right, let's make like a tree and get out of here. North to Alaska. North, the rush is on.
Vinita traffic, Skyhawk 314XR, departing 35. I'm going to be departing to the northwest, Vinita.
Departing to the great North Alaska.
Where's your little coyote friend? He's still up there.
I don't know. He's
right there on the edge.
Yeah, he's still there. I think he's pooping right there on that light. With George Pratt, his partner and brother. Got a tailwind right there at the last second. That was odd. But you did the right thing, you pitched down.
Got a little wind up here.
Yeah. Vinita traffic, Skyhawk 3148XRA, departing the airspace to the northwest. 1,200 climbing 4,500. Vinita.
Oh, got somebody out there, but he's 600 feet below us.
Okay. That actually might be the crop duster that just took off.
Oh.
So we're not going to really be flying through any crazy airspace on this first leg. We're going to be going through a couple MOAs. I'm not super concerned about those. We can totally go through MOAs. We're VFR.
Bye.
Up in Salina, we'll be going over the top of, well, we'll be going to the top and right of Salina. And then that's basically it until we hit Lexington. And there's not a whole lot there. I just picked that airfield because they have cheap fuel and they have courtesy cars, so that sounded like a good decision to me.
Yep, sounds good.
Yeah, so we actually moved our families up to Alaska, what, 2.5 weeks ago?
Yes.
And took, I think, 5 days to get up there driving. And we had a pretty big convoy, two big trucks with two long trailers and an SUV. And boy, that was quite the adventure. Took off in at the end of September, got back at the beginning of October. So we actually ran into a little bit of snow on the way up there. And, you know, it's some pretty scenery, but boy, that was a long trip. And it took us 5 days. And we're going to see if this trip can actually be done quicker. We're planning for 4 days. We've got some extra days on the back end. I think we've got as much as 2 weeks if we need to. But we'll see what happens. And then we're also going to cross the border, and we'll show you guys some border ops. I've never actually crossed in a small plane, so we're going to see how this goes.
On the first leg, there really wasn't a lot of great scenery, but the winds definitely made up for that. So we already got an adventure on the first leg because of those winds, and a little bit of turbulence too.
Okay, so we've had a little bit of a slight development. Our initial point was scheduled to be about 3 hours and 45 minutes long, and we're actually leaning closer to 4 hours and some change. And so what we ended up doing is picking a field about 30 minutes closer on the southeast side of our original point. That way we're 100% legal when we land, because I'm a little bit sketched out about the fuel. How about you?
Yeah, me too, yes. And after looking at it here.
Yeah, and even the fuel gauges seem to be scraping the bottom of the barrel here, but we should still land with 30 minutes of fuel reserves, just like we're supposed to do. But that's just the way it is sometimes when you plan for long legs like this. Sometimes you have a stronger wind than what you anticipated.
Well, the first leg was only supposed to take about three hours and 45 minutes. Now, we both kind of looked at the winds, but you know, when you hit a 20 to 25 mile headwind, we pushed close to 5 hours, obviously burned more fuel. And with that plane being slow as it is already, that was a slow, long trip for the first leg.
Headwind, booster field, automated weather observation, 2025 weather, wind, 310-14-23, visibility, 10-0,
this landing's going to be fun either way.
That's why I let you have it.
Yeah, after 4 hours of flying.
I know, it's brutal. But I think this was scheduled to be the longest.
I think it was.
The whole trip.
Yep, I
agree. Most of them were scheduled to be quite a bit shorter. Not quite a bit, but shorter in some way. So. And then we still got to fly 30 minutes more to our...
Exactly, yeah.
That's just been kicking us all day long.
Yep.
That, direct, you know, 17 knot headwind. It's just brutal. All right, we're a mile from Boolia. Go ahead and throw those on. I got the controls for a second. All right, your controls.
My controls.
Your controls. Brewster traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray. 10 miles to the south on the RNAV 36 full stop, Brewster. I know this is not ideal after a 4 hour flight, but. Brewster traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray. 3 miles to the south. Straight in for 3-6, Brewster.
Even though it's already been a long leg, I thought it'd be a good idea to practice an instrument approach. It's a good excuse to make a straight in, and Mike's working on his instrument rating anyways.
Well, I started the flight from Vinita, and it was about a 4 hour flight, and then we did hit some winds, which was, gave us a strong headwind, but boy, when we hit that first airport landing, we wanted to do an instrument approach, which we attempted, but the winds were so terrible at that airport, it was a rough landing.
Boy, it's rough.
Yeah, it is.
Okay. I know you're still high, but my controls, take those off. All right, your controls.
My controls.
Your controls. Good grief.
Yeah, let's go.
Oh, I gotta pee so bad.
What's the name of this airport?
Brewster.
Brewster traffic, Skyhawk 314 X-ray, clearly active.
Taxiing over field, Brewster.
What a wind. That thing is like going from straight to left to everywhere.
After trying to hold down the airplane and fuel it up at the same time, we're ready to head on to our destination.
Okay, my controls.
Your controls.
Fuel selector valve on both, flaps are coming up, cabin air is off, brakes are good. We'll do a quick run up. We won't dwell too long on one spot, but I do want to do a run up. My flight controls are still good after all those beatings. Curve heat's off, landing lights coming on. Alright, final's clear. All right, carb heat's off. Landing and taxi lights on. Fuel selector valve on both. Mixture best power. Flaps are up. Ready to go?
Yep, I'm just looking for...
Final's clear. First of traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray taking 3-6 for a west departure. Brewster. Well, it's like 6 of one and half a dozen of the other. See that?
Yeah.
All right, airspeed is coming alive. Woo, it
well,
is
we are all over.
Brutal. That's just... Well, I wonder why you struggled there. Golly. That is nice.
Hard to close. You're off now. You're getting your speed built up.
I'm doing this.
Oh, yeah, so you can.
That is unreal.
There's your 70. Wow.
That's pretty brutal.
Don't even look like we're moving.
All right, landing lights off, flaps up, after takeoff checklist is complete. Let's see if I can do any better over this other runway. Golly. That was pretty neat. And Brewster traffic, Skyhawk 314 X-ray, departing the airspace to the northwest. Brewster. All right, now off to our final stop for the day, and then the winds are supposed to die down completely, so maybe I'll get an easy landing. All right, pattern altitude 3,500. We're going to go ahead and head down. Already got the winds. Pretty gusty over here, too, but mine's more of a straight down the pipe. All right, seatbelts on, fuel selector valve on both, mixture best power.
North flat traffic, arrow 258 in Quebec is final for 30 north flat.
Turn that landing light on. Oh, good grief, I got bumpy all of a sudden. That's kind of pretty.
Yeah.
I don't know what river that is, but.
Flat River.
Flat River? That's borderline moderate turbulence right there. Alright, seatbelts on, fuel selector valve on both, mixture best power. Already got the landing and taxi lights on. I'll get the rest here in just a second. Yeah, see, look, I will get pushed right here. Lexington traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray. Approach in downwind, left approach in downwind for 32, Lexington. We're in the white arc, first notch of flaps. I might just keep it here at one notch, just because we have some serious winds.
Yeah, but like I say, at least it'd be right, hopefully straight out down the pike here, but yeah, we'll see if they're moving around any.
Lexington traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray, left base 32, Lexington. Oh, we are getting pushed. This is going to land at 70.
Traffic, Skyhawk 317, Bravo, Tango, 4 miles. 3 miles to the northwest.
Landed 7,500,
money bearing gunning.
At 75 with these gusts. Lexington traffic, Skyhawk 3148 X-ray, 2 mile final, 32, Lexington. Yes, I can tell it's not going to be quite as bad as.
Well, no, of course you get that.
That's when you get surprised by a sneak attack wind blast when you think you're doing good. Yeah, like those right there. I'll just carry a little power. I don't care if I have to back tack. Little balloon. Oh, I might be able to make this.
Got it. Hey, there's a couple cars here. That's good.
Well, we made it to our first stop, and the winds weren't quite as bad for me as they were for you, thankfully. Oh, but that was pretty eventful first day.
Yes, it was.
That looks like that might be a courtesy car. So
the white one or the green truck?
The white one. Hopefully the white one.
All right, we're down on the ground here at Lexington, Nebraska. I have no clue where that is. Getting the airplane all secured, and we're gonna go hit up the FBO before it closes and see if we can find a courtesy car. I'm pretty sure this is an old police interceptor. Ooh, I bet this thing's got some power. All right, we're headed to the hotel, and I can finally hear myself think. How about those winds?
That was something.
That was ridiculous is what that was. Mine wasn't so bad, but you had some pretty gusty crosswinds, I will say.
Yes, I did.
And after a long day of flying, we finally arrived at our hotel for some much-needed rest and cookies. Oh yeah, and I knocked out the paperwork to hopefully get us across the border. In the next episode, we're going to be continuing the journey and crossing that Canadian border. Will the Canadian Border Patrol throw someone else in this family in prison? Find out in the next episode of Adventure Man.
When I grow up, I want to be a bush pilot, and don't shake your head.